Gojo Satoru, the inheritor of the Six Eyes and Limitless, and the only one capable of taking on a Ten Shadows Ryomen Sukuna. At this point in Jujutsu Kaisen, he is the last hope our characters have left. Ten Shadows is looking pretty OP, and that Dharma Chakra, well, that thing's busted. But you know what else is busted? The Six Eyes. Gojo may have been born in a weaker era of sorcerers, but Gojo Satoru is not just a big fish in a small pond. This guy is a megalodon. Gojo makes incredibly powerful sorcerers like Kenjaku just say no thanks. Because unless a brain's hunting you as an infant, with the Six Eyes, you don't get no diffed. Even though Gojo can't solve every single problem the protagonists are currently facing, he's still definitely gonna make it better. Right now, with the Culling Games, we have all of these ancient sorcerers just running around. But when they meet Gojo Satoru, they're gonna wish they never came back. Despite recent events having people a little shaken, Gojo is still incredibly powerful. His curse energy reinforcement alone is top of the verse. Even if everyone in Shibuya had teamed up on him, he would have still won, no diff. He's truly top of the line in every single regard, and there's a reason that Ryomen Sukuna was Kenjaku's only backup plan. Because just like only Gojo can fight Ryomen Sukuna, only Ryomen Sukuna can fight Gojo Satoru. And Gojo is getting out of that box, and to say that he's going to be pissed when he gets out is putting it mildly. Upon his release, he'll have to deal with the fact that Megumi's body is stolen by Ryomen Sukuna, not to mention everyone else lost in Shibuya. This is going to be a more serious Gojo than we've ever seen, because there is no time to waste. For the first time in Jujutsu Kaisen, Gojo will need the help of others, because Gojo can't be everywhere at once. They're going to have to deal with the fallout of the merger or stop it entirely. Get Megumi back and put down Ryomen Sukuna once and for all, because the world of Jujutsu Kaisen has changed forever. The governments of the world are aware of Jujutsu, cursed energy, and Gojo Satoru, and Lieutenant General Gary Johnson's love of anime won't be enough to mull things over. The situation has changed forever. This will truly be the last-ditch effort to set things right, and Gojo is going to be a huge part of it. Gojo is not the honored jobber. Even if a 20-finger Sukuna is stronger, Gojo still has a role to play beyond just being there to die. This character doesn't get a poor send-off. He and Maki are the two most developed supporting characters in the entire series, besides maybe Yuta. Gojo got an entire flashback arc dedicated to his development and how his ideology formed. Gojo fans rejoice because win or lose, this guy will have his moment to shine. Because right now, there is no ancient sorcerer outside of Ryomen Sukuna that can stand in this guy's way. And yes, a Ten Shadows Ryomen Sukuna has proven to be one of the most powerful characters we have ever seen in Jujutsu Kaisen. And let's not sleep on the fact that this Dharma Chakra is incredibly hacked. I've seen some downplay around this thing. No, this thing heals the user after the fact and adapts as a late throw. It is ridiculously overpowered. And it's attached to a guy who was already ridiculously overpowered. There is no need to downplay this thing's adaptation. It is stated to adapt to any and all phenomena. It doesn't really get more blatant than that. And it already was shown to interact with infinite pressure. Given that statement, until there is a confirmed limitation beyond stacking abilities while it's adapting, there is no reason to believe this thing struggles to adapt to anything. And while it is most certainly going to have a weakness eventually, right now it is OP. This will be the fight of Gojo's life, and win or lose, this will likely be the first and last time we see Gojo Satoru get pushed. There is no need to downplay either one of these characters because they are both exceptionally powerful, and in this fight, nobody is going to get stomped. Gojo and Sukuna are both going to pull out things we have never seen from them, because they're going to have to, because that's what this fight is. In this battle, Gojo has to accomplish something against Ryomen Sukuna or he wipes the verse. Because if a full power Ryomen Sukuna with 10 shadows is still around after a battle with Gojo Satoru, that is an unstoppable force that even Kenjaku did not expect. Megumi was never part of Kenjaku's expectations when it came to Ryomen Sukuna, but there is no world Gojo does not give Sukuna a bloody nose. This fight is one of the most built-up fights in this entire series. We have obvious foreshadowing to it in recent chapters, and when these chapters come out, the internet is going to lose its mind. Because this is what the best battles in Shonen are built on. The OP sensei coming out to last stand a villain. And win or lose, his impact in this fight is going to be felt throughout the rest of the series. In the past, Rico's death was the turning point for Gojo and his hatred of the current society, and when he became the first Six Eyes user to break from fate with Tengen. And I believe this was the moment when he truly started to form his dream and bring up the next generation to share his ideals of a better Jujutsu society. Because Gojo never really got over the loss of Rico and his best friend. And the beef he has with Ryomen Sukuna went up dramatically when he stole Megumi from him. Gojo trained Megumi personally and brought him up to make sure he had a future. One that Sukuna stole from him, and one that Gojo will stop at nothing to give back to him. Because underneath his goofy demeanor, Gojo truly cares about everyone. We see this in his inner thoughts in Shibuya, where Gojo goes out of his way to avoid injuring innocent people who he's never even met before. And this is why he saves characters like Yuto Okotsu and Yuji Itadori from being executed by the higher-ups. Many have asked if the higher-ups were correct in executing them, maybe in the short term. But in the long term, saving them will prove the correct choice. Because unlike Kenjaku, Gojo sees the potential of Yuto Okotsu. And this is part of the reason I believe that the final defeat of Kenjaku will in large part fall on the shoulders of Yuta, and why Yuji Itadori must play a major role in the final defeat of Ryomen Sukuna. Because it was Gojo Satoru's ideology and decision that saved both of them. Many go to power scaling and say that Gojo overestimates his own students, and I think that this is intentional and that Gojo is the only one who truly looks for what these people may become. And that's why he saves someone like Yuta, who becomes a special grade, and someone like Yuji Itadori, who has incredible potential. Even when Gojo was sealed, he remained calm, because his faith in his decisions and the students he brought up was that great. That's how strong his belief in his ideology is. And this is where Kenjaku and Gojo differ the most, because Gojo sees the potential of his students, not just their current power levels. And this is what's going to bite Kenjaku in the ass, and that's what makes the setup to Gojo versus Sukuna so amazing. Because Sukuna having stolen Megumi puts Gojo in a difficult situation, because Gojo can't fix all the problems in the story right now, but he can give all the other characters a fighting chance. And the thing that Sukuna and Kenjaku underestimate about Gojo Satoru is that he'll fight tooth and nail to ensure his student's future, even if it costs him his life. Because until they're strong enough, he'll do whatever he can to give them that opportunity to grow. And he is going to pull out all the stops against Ryomen Sukuna and show him just how strong his conviction really is. Because even if a 10 Shadows Megumi turns out to be stronger than Gojo, he'll fight regardless, because his faith in his students is that strong that they'll be able to pick up where he left off. But that's just my opinion, and now I want to hear yours, so let me know what you think about Gojo and his upcoming fight. And if you like Jujutsu Kaisen and anime content, there's plenty more on this channel, so subscribe for more. And as always, thanks for watching.